Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Brenttime, and today I've got episode 4 of our Dreamfall Chapters. This is episode 4B. The other episode you can watch will be linked with an annotation. It is the same thing. It's a little bit longer, but it only has my commentary. The game sound is not in it. This will have game sound, so don't you worry. So this is going to be a lot more fast-paced, because I know exactly what's going to happen, because I've already played through it all. Unfortunately, last time there was just a lot of, there was just an issue with recording the sound, and I have fixed it, and now we shall play. So we're going to head to the political campaign area, which is just right up here, and we are going to bump this.
Not again. When did this happen?
Hey, Sissy. Last night, the fascists even saluted the camera. Bloody Omegas. Think they're untouchable.
Do you need any help?
With this? I got it. There's more important things for you to do.
You should get a decommissioned military drone from Mira. Go ballistic on their asses. Yeehaw! Yeah, that'd teach them.
Behind this sweet facade lurks a lioness. It's tempting, but then we'd have to deal with the eye as well. I'll just keep cleaning up the mess until Constantine's goons admit defeat. Oh, by the way, Sissy, did you see the update? Eish! 2 points! Not bad. Not bad.
I'm gonna keep what
no,
I said
but
pretty
one
much
moment,
the same.
Let me check your stream.
So.
Oh, hey, that's fantastic! We're heading in the right direction.
Our biggest jump in weeks. Ha! 2 points. That's something to celebrate. Uminska invited all the managers to join her tonight in Warsaw for the live feed.
You going?
If I finish up in time, of course. When did I ever say no to a party? I have a plus one, if you're interested.
I know this is important to Baruti, and I know I'm not... I can't tonight. I already have plans with Reza. Sorry.
That's okay, Sissy. Short notice. I know. I'll ask Asif. How was Trieste? I think I see a tan.
Good. They have this thing in the sky. I don't know what it's called. It's big and yellow and made of fire and it's super hot. So awesome.
I remember the sun from Botswana. They have that there too. But it's much bigger. And much nicer.
Meh. You're such a warm dasher, Baruti. Who needs the sun when you have the clammy, sticky heat of Propast in July? So what's the plan, Stan?
Today, there's delicate work to do. Do you know Queenie?
Queenie? Wait. The babka on the boat, out by the bricks?
That's her.
How does an old woman stand up to all...
When you meet Queenie, and that...
Me. Me. Baruti...
Even if that's true, I can.
Yeah, so...
Pay Queenie our respects. Let her know that she's a friend to the party.
And... I'm sensing an and...
Ask her for her support.
So that's all.
That's all.
Cryptocoin?
Okay.
Have you ever shot an... I've loaded it...
Wait. Gotcha.
Mark, when you...
So I'm gonna explain to you exactly what he's telling us to do. So, he's telling Zoe that she needs to go to the docks and find this old woman named Queenie. Queenie is kind of like this... respectable elder that everyone, like, she has an opinion and everyone follows behind her opinion with no questions asked because she's the voice, she's the sort of opinion of the people or, you know, decider of the people kind of
thing. I'm just a guy.
Everyone follows her because they trust her. So we need her on our side because anyone else has her, then they'll get a ton of votes or, you know, whatever the thing is. Can't afford that. So, Queenie is right over in Chinatown. She's on the Queenie boat, which is right there. Not the Chinese food, the one right behind it. It's right over here. And this little girl is going to tell us that we're going to need a gift to see Queenie. And I'm going to show you how to get that gift real fast.
How old can she be? 14?
Good day. Welcome.
I'm looking for Queenie. I'm not shopping.
That depends.
Bring anything.
Madame Queenie is a respect, a gift.
What would that?
I'm sure you'll
Okay. So first you need to talk to this about this baijiu.
What was it again? Baijiu? That bottle of...
Baijiu! This one is...
Sounds expensive.
For you!
20,000!
A bargain! Look! The price tag says 30,000!
Well, I don't have...
I'd be losing...
Alright, so he'll say it's 20,000. He'll be like, oh, hell no.
No, that's clavada, a total like, ripoff.
Way too expensive.
I'll give you 350 for it, and not
so
one ply more.
350? Are you mocking me? That's less than what I...
Oh, for God's sake. You're 10 yuan apart. You know what? I'm paying the difference.
Point on the lady.
Withdraw it. Can you guys please...
What? How dare
this guy's gonna get pissed.
Sorry?
Nothing? Scheiße! Look, down there on the ground. No, I won't lose face because of this... this duper. And paying the full sticker price. What is it? 1,200 yuan? Here, take all of it. All of it!
You should...
Never
mind.
That bottle
you have made with short
sound.
What's that?
All
nothing.
Right.
Seems generous. What are you pointing?
Okay, now I told her I'll pay that much, and she's like, or now she reduced the price, and I'm gonna tell this guy that she reduced the price over there.
How come that woman over there is selling the exact same wine for only 5,000 yuan?
What? That no good dishonest thief! She's selling a cheap counterfeit, maybe the lowest of low-grade synthetic rice in importance. But I don't want you to suffer because of her dishonesty and chick.
From 20. Still two.
That is.
Alright, so it's too low there. Now we're actually gonna buy it from this lady.
I found an.
What?
Or it's too same. High.
Not
sure.
Wait, can't believe.
Alright.
I hope you're...
There we go. We got the baijiu, and now we can go back to the dock.
This is a bottle of, baijiu. Rare seeds, clean water, hand-picked, distilled with rare rice.
So I can see. I'm sorry, but Queenie get...
This isn't cheap, honest. It's a really great bottle of wine.
You're in the bricks. Price tags are transient. One moment, please. Yes, madame? This will suffice as a gift. Thank you. You can go across
right.
And see... Just put your gift...
Thanks.
Queenie wants to see us. No, you're going to be on the list.
Step softly, young lady. The vibrations are throwing off my precision.
Oops. Sorry.
Tut tut. No talking either. We're closed today, but seeing as you got past my girl, I guess you have legitimate business.
Yeah. Hiya. Well, sort of.
Yes?
I'm with the Uminska campaign. Uminska, Leia. Unity?
I'm quite familiar with the Social Democrats, girl. You work with Baruti Marfane, then?
Yeah. Yes.
He's a nice man, genuine. You can tell he believes in his work. Do you?
What?
Why are you in politics, young lady?
Zoe, Castillo. I'm, in politics because... Well, because part of it is because I want to make a difference. I want to make a difference, and I have the time to spare. But the truth is that
Very well. Let me rephrase that question. Whittle it down for you. Why Uminska?
Because the alternatives are so bad. Kaiser Wolf, Dieter Gross. Why Uminska? Maybe the honest answer is that I don't know. It's the campaign I ended up working for. She's certainly better than Kaiser Wolf. Probably better than Dieter Gross and the incumbent, because there's no one else.
Perhaps there isn't. It's not the most passionate or convincing of arguments. If you're here to sell me on the idea of supporting her campaign, you're doing a frankly terrible job of it.
Well, yes. Here's the thing. Maybe the hard sell will come across as dishonest. Seems like no. You know what? I'm not even going to try. It's not going to sound heartfelt or honest enough for her. Do you want Constantine Wolf to run Europolis?
Now is not the time for politics. Not yet. I want to know what really bothers you, Senorita Castillo. What are you looking for? Be honest with yourself.
Perhaps I want to remember what happened to me before the coma.
There. That wasn't so hard, was it?
I'm so, so, so sorry. That was really inappropriate. I don't even know why I... Really inappropriate.
Not at all. Now I know who I'm speaking with. Shall we discuss politics?
Really? Yeah. All right. So, we, Leo Uminska, the Social Democrats, we're wondering if you would...
Support Uminska and the Social Democrats in the election, I know. I'm thinking about it. You see, Zoe, the most important thing for me is this community and the people who look to me for guidance and support. They trust me and my judgment. I know that I have to take a political stand, and I know that stand will have implications and repercussions. The Blues have left me alone, never bothered me. Dieter Gross is a safe choice, the status quo. Wolf, I do not trust. I have no wish to see him or his European Dawn thugs in power. The consequences of that would be on the scary side of unknown. The Marxists are preoccupied with rhetoric, demonstrations and marches, grand speeches and even grander gestures. I don't think they'll get in my way, but they do get on my nerves. And we have your Social Democrats. They are the compromise. I usually abhor compromises. In this case, however, the extremes aren't very attractive. And so it comes down to this. Prove to me that your party cares about this community and the people in it, and you'll have my support. That's what politics means to me.
Yeah. Okay, fair enough. How do I prove that?
The I's been increasingly successful at keeping undesirables off the streets. That doesn't mean they're not here still. There's a city beneath the city, populated by those who have fallen through the cracks. People with no home, no identity. Old, young, children. There's a girl, a young girl, Hannah Roth. I was in contact with her, but now she's fallen off my radar. Help Hannah. Find her. Tell her Queenie is looking for her. If you do this for me...
I'll do my best.
Nella Vilch.
Up top.
No code.
What's that? I'll start...
Queen.
She said there are so many lost people. She looks ready to get back to work and... Well...
I'm coming.
All right. So now we got a job from Queenie. Nella is the woman we got food from way up there. So, we need to first get up there to do that. We need to head this way, head up that ramp, and get up to the top. And remember, guys, if you haven't seen our prior episodes, please hit the back annotation. You can watch all the episodes. Episode 4A will be in the middle of the, at the middle top, or I'll say 4A, because I do want you, if you want more commentary by myself, to get that.
After what Reza told me about that dreamer soft drink, I'm never...
the best dream time.
No, I mean, I lie. I am a bit curious to try it. I mean, actually seeing the bingo dingo? It sounds awesome.
The bingo dingo.
You are
so proud.
It's you! Anywhere
in who? Me?
The superhero from my dream! You're her!
Sorry? I really don't... I'm not her, whoever she is.
Yes, you were in my dream! You told me it'd be alright. And it was!
Episode.
You helped me wake up!
You're mistaken. I don't even own a dream machine. I could couldn't possibly have been in your dreams.
It was you. You were there. I don't use it much anymore. The dream machine. Most of the time, I say no, just like you told me to. I read instead. I'm reading a lot. The book I'm reading right now is about this girl who's dreaming, but doesn't know she's dreaming. I'm worried about Mum. She's always in dream time. She prefers that to being awake. She doesn't eat much, or go outside, ever. Thank you for helping me. Zoe, right? Thank you, Zoe.
How do you... I didn't... What?
Alright, so...
What was that all about? I don't know her. Do I? She looked...
Gone to restock. Back soon. Oh.
Okay, so...
Crowboy is here to help you find your way in progress.
I don't know her in this world, but I know her in dream time. So, like...
It's between Wolf and Ominska, isn't it? Ross and Rebus are...
Like the sage, or I can't remember his name exactly. Like he said, I need to make sure I, like, listen to these people. That'll help me get back to who I am from story time. So...
There's no way you can convince me that Kaiser
Constantine...
Alright,
so what we're doing right now is we're heading down to find Nelly. Nelly's at a restock place. A restock place is just right around here. You take this corner that's coming up and you head straight and you'll hit her little restocking place. She'll be talking to someone that we don't really know who it is, and this ends all our whole little political this doesn't end the political thing just yet, but we only have one more cutscene after this for the political campaign, and then we do the end of Zoe's campaign, and then we do another thing.
Look, Adzi, I said I'd do my part.
That is exactly what you said.
But I have to draw the line somewhere. I'm all about shifting the balance of power, huh? About getting the Bonza to think twice. Not about fucking shit up just for the sake of fucking shit up. That's not what I signed up for. I want to pick up my supplies and get back to feeding the barrio. If I can convert some sozies and battleheads while I'm at it, great. If not, I move on.
That don't sound like someone's committed to the cause.
Oh, fuck off. I'm delivering as promised, no? I'm getting a friend to source me the nanotech. She has special access, a couple of days, week at most. But with the eye poking into my affairs, committing random acts of personal violation, drones and checkpoints everywhere. Time to tread a little more cautiously, lest we find ourselves bereft of food card, food, and freedom. Anything else you need me for, Bruda, I'm all game.
I remember you saying you'd walk the walk, not just talk the talk.
I need to draw my line somewhere, and this is where I draw it.
Whatever, as long as you deliver.
Kolo, seriously, when do I not?
Alright.
Puta, Dupec, what are you doing here?
I was just... you weren't at the cart, so I went looking.
You went looking? Are you spying on me, Zike?
Jesus, Enspanella, no. I wanted to ask you about Hannah Roth.
Hannah? Hannah? What the hell for?
I need to find her.
That doesn't answer my question, and you won't find her. She's... Shayaza, just stop. Stop looking, stop asking, and stop following me. This is not something you want to get involved in. Just let it go, and go. Get out of here. You're not going to find... Go! Get the fuck out of here!
So she's clearly pissed. We're not going to get any information out of her. So our next stop is going to be the political campaign sector. And we're going to see Baruda again. So let's go ahead and move our asses down there. Hi, operative.
Nothing to see here.
Hello, my friend. You're not in a rush, are you? Shalom, farewell,
sir. Mr. London ain't too happy with how you're messing about in his barrio, Sozy.
Easy, cousin.
I ain't your cousin, mate. I ain't your mate, neither. Mr. London says you ain't never asked for his blessings, Kolo. Mr. London, he ain't too happy about that, him. Mr. London says it's disrespectful.
Tell Mr. London that I'm not messing with anything. I'm just running a political campaign.
Maybe if we could have a civil discussion about this, instead of...
Oi, Essie! You talk to me, not to Mr. Landon. No one talks to Mr. Landon! And there's no discussion to be had. We have no use for your commie comrades in Propast. In this barrio, we vote wolf!
Oh, I see what's going on. This isn't about Tef or respect, is it? It's about Kaiser Constantine and his fascial...
Hey! Let him go! Wait, what? Was that me?
Otherwise, don't get involved, Suka. You just get your press messed up.
I didn't understand any of that, but if you don't let him go, I'm calling the police.
Appella? Scheiss a minute. You think the police are going to interfere? Do you know who this is? Now fuck off before I get total anger pissed and decide to...
一個旅行的商人沿途為他的商品叫賣，我的盾牌商人。
Yes, this guy's speaking Cantonese, and I really don't feel like listening to it. It's not even like cool. It's just stupid. And he's got link ears that are fake because he put gold.
I don't speak Cantonese. Just let.
That's Mr. London. He's got a beer belly.
And let that be a lesson to you, cootass. This is Mr. London's barrio. And the sooner you get that through your cocoa, the less mal you'll need to deal with.
Like what? Like, I understand when it's convenient for you to, like, you know, shit out of people with something.
Although...
But why do you have a 9-iron?
I'm not sure it was this much.
I couldn't just stop.
I am.
Do you need any?
I'm fine. They're not...
Okay.
Let's talk...
I understand.
I won't up.
Take care.
Alright. I don't feel like dealing with Birdie right now. Basically, he talks about how he's just gonna stay inside there. And, yeah, that's what we wanted to do. Alright, now we're gonna head back home. Which back home is just up through here. It's at the Sunset Square, or whatever it's called. So we do need to head up the ramp, which will be right up here. Actually, maybe we don't. I think this is actually the wrong way.
Who am I visiting? No one. That's who I'm visiting.
You're disrupting traffic. Keep walking.
So I'm really excited for when book two comes out, and I will be making a first impressions episode of this first book. I will also be doing sort of a review thing and talking
you
about
whether
or not
week.
I recommend you to get this now or recommend you to get this after a few more books come out. And I'll give you a little sneak thing. I recommend that you wait until at least two books are out. Or if you do get a nice deal through the G2A link that's in the video description below, you could probably get this game at about $10 off, which puts you at a very nice $20. For $20, if it's only one episode,
so
one book right now,
you can't pass through here, Bruder. You need to turn back and head home.
Extra $10 that you can use on maybe the first game in the series, which is only $10. You know, pass on your savings. And yeah. Alright, so this is our house, or this is where our house is. So let's go ahead and let's head home. There's our boyfriend.
Hey.
Ooh, smells good. What are you making?
Risotto. Come over here.
Nice to see you too. I needed that.
Why? What's going on?
We had a real scare at the campaign office.
What happened?
Baruti got pushed around by Mr. London's goons and London himself.
Jesus, is he okay?
He's fine. He's probably fine.
How about you? Are you okay?
I'm okay. They didn't touch me.
But you got involved.
I had to.
Yep.
I couldn't just let them do that to Baruti.
I really wish you'd stayed out of it. You don't know what those people are capable of.
They're just cowards.
Cowards with the might of the syndicate behind them.
Still just cowards. Look, I'll be okay. They wanted to scare Baruti. Nothing's gonna happen. They're not gonna come after me.
About earlier. I'm sorry I pushed your therapy buttons. I didn't mean to pry.
Don't worry about it, Rez. I was tired. I'm okay talking. Really. And I do feel better.
It's helping?
It's helping. Mostly because of you.
Let's hope you don't change your mind after this risotto.
How was your day?
Not as interesting as yours. I published that bingo piece. Now I'm following up the leads on the clampdown.
It's getting ridiculous out there. Everyone's on edge.
I know the campaign work is important to you, but you need to be careful about getting involved in local affairs. Even Sully doesn't want us to write too much about what's happening here in Propast.
If you stop reporting things because you're afraid of what will happen, you're censoring yourself.
We need to pick our battles. Like that Mr. London business. He shakes businesses down, runs the local black market. Bad, sure, but not corporate level bad. Or Kaiser Constantine bad.
I guess.
I'm not happy about it either, but sometimes you need to let the small fish go in order to catch the bigger fish.
I get that. Maybe I'm an idealist.
We both are. But I'm also a realist. And I really wish you'd drop the campaign work. Hey, come over here and taste this.
I don't like his toe.
That will affect our relationship. Son of a bitch.
How is it?
It's good. Really good. I can't wait to eat. I'll pay you back afterwards.
For what?
Cooking the best dinners, being the best boyfriend, knowing how to make me feel better.
Do we have to wait until after dinner?
Won't the risotto be ruined?
Is that important?
Not in the slightest. Don't just say you love me, show me.
Okay, this isn't... I don't know who that is. That could be Kaiser Constantine, I guess. But he bugged our apartment, which isn't good. He wants something. Some kind of info or something like that. Now we switch to the best part of the entire book one. Get ready for epicness. Here we go. We're almost there. There it is! Yes! It's about to happen. Oh, yeah. I'm a baby. I got this. Or don't. I'm furious at this shit.
Sleeping? Playing? Plotting our downfall? I don't
and
know.
Boom!
She's in a crib and
concussion.
Suspiciously quiet.
Good. That's good.
And you're not listening to a word I'm saying. How's the story coming?
Don't ask.
I'm a
all
baby!
Right. So when can I read it?
Look how happy I am! This is the best thing ever. I'm just so happy. Everything is so great right now. Haha, Dad, you don't see me. Look how happy I am. I'm having the best of times.
Hey, is there anything you want me to bring back this time?
Do we have to talk about that right now?
I'm leaving tomorrow.
I don't like it when you leave.
Just be stealthy.
I worry when you leave.
I thought the whole point of building this house was so that we wouldn't have to worry so much anymore.
Oh, I'll always worry. But I'll always come back to you.
This is our anchor. In time and space. In all worlds.
Sorry.
Past, present, and future.
You're starting to sound like a real estate agent.
Recently renovated, low in... Hey, Saga. Are you up and about? Does Papa know you're here? I don't think Papa knows.
He
don't
doesn't
worry.
Know.
It'll be our little secret.
Perfect.
Hey, baby, Mama's working. Give me a minute. 1 second, Saga.
No.
I'm just finishing this one sentence. Almost. Almost. There. Right.
Watch.
What do you want?
Watch the happy baby. Watch the happy baby. I want to go in here.
The door? You want me to open the door for you? I can do that. There you go. Now, don't go into the fireplace again and get ashes all over the place, okay?
Where the fuck was your child in the fireplace room, even when they fought in the fireplace once before? How is that a good idea? It doesn't matter.
Hello, Saga.
Bye. Get the light.
You're growing so fast, little one. Soon you will talk and remember and see with other eyes. Eyes that can no longer see me. There's so much of me in you, sister daughter. I know you cannot understand me now, but I want you to know that I will watch you and protect you.
And
over time, our link will weaken, and you will be blind to me. But I will still be right here. Tomorrow, in 10 years, for as long as you live.
I'm gonna live a billion years.
And at the end, my sister, my daughter, we will reunite. The circle will be complete. The worlds rejoined, balance restored. The stories we will tell each other. I'll see you soon, my little Saga. May the balance be with you always.
Like the Force. May the Force be with
you. Who are you talking to, Saga? What's all the babbling about?
Except on the microphone.
Is she in there? How in the stars did she get out?
Magic, honey. It sounded like she was talking to someone.
Hey, how did you go, baby girl? Did you sprout wings and fly?
There's someone else in the house, Magnus. I can feel it.
I don't feel anything. Don't worry, Etta. No one but us could ever get inside. It's impossible.
I hope you're right.
Come here, baby. I'm a blue mommy. Come here. Captain Planet!
I could have sworn there was somebody.
Right. She actually recycles
them. Oh,
ooh. It's all about planet.
Papa's not the only one making stew.
That's because I'm great at it. That's her stirring stick. Teehee. And well, guys, that's book one of Dreamfall Chapters. I do hope you enjoyed it. If you want more commentary and a longer kind of episode, please do hit 4A. It's a hell of a lot longer. It's about an hour and 20 minutes, I think it will be, unless I split it into two, which makes a hell of a lot more sense. Because, I mean, that'll make it, you know, 40 minutes each, which is a lot more reasonable for a YouTube video. I do hope you enjoyed it. I will see you guys in the next one. Thank you.